guys, Broker Bros, and welcome back to my FIFA's team, Leo Carimo. Where last time off, I beat Nice in the league, and with the inner workings of my transfer or deadline. Okay, but and I also signed a new player. Not on deadline day, I signed him just before deadline day. And you can see him there too far. And yes, he is getting his debut. Because why not? Now, about why I am wearing my alternative kit instead of my home kit. See, I'm up against Monaco, whose kit and my kit clash. Because my home kit is white with a bit of red in it. Monaco's away kit is like a creamish color. Which, nah, it's just too similar. Pretty much, it's white, it's yellow. Oh, which is... Well, the bit of red would help. It's just having a totally different color kit would... It's just going to make things way easier. Now, well, I can't make Monaco wear their home kit because their home kit is white and red. And they don't have a third kit because they're idiots. And I looked in the store, they don't have an alternative kit, so, or a historic kit that might be of a different color. Apparently, they've worn the same kit forever. So, I'm wearing my alternative kit. It's a different color. So, we can actually tell which team is which. And we're not totally confused by everyone wearing the same color. And the only difference being the arrows and the bit of red on one team's jerseys. This way, much easier. So that's why I am wearing the alternative kit instead of the home kit.
Well, he's thanking the corner kick taker.
The fantastic start. And here, this shot is deflected in by the dude on the line. Should still be his goal, and it is. Beautiful. 1-0 inside 5 minutes. That is brilliant.
Trib. Made the challenge well. Here it is now with Leal.
Good challenge by Mavuba.
This could be a jump.
Oh, perfect. Oh, could be 2-0 off the post. Oh, could have been a quick fire double. Also, really put Monaco behind the eight ball. But no such joy on that occasion.
Good football between these two. Nice passing. Good strong tackle. Trying to thread it through here. We could be in.
Brutal.
Looked very good indeed, but the...
Of course, I'm thinking there'll be a penalty because he got the ball.
The away team come here having drawn their last two games, which is a competitive streak. Maybe not quite the winning mentality.
Okay.
You wonder whether a draw here would be satisfactory.
Square door. The Brutal!
Probably deserved a bit better from it.
Yeah, he's one of the best headers of the ball in this league, I think. Well, he was in the right place at the
moment. Come on, give me an option. Yes, the Prevot. Oh, surely, third time's the charm. No, the keeper with a fantastic save. Here, secure. Send here. Send here. In the excitement, I called him something else. Sekir. Sounds like I'm trying to say his name mixed with it, with that Sekir from Link. Oh. Sekir. It's Lopez! And after not stopping in the last episode, Lopez scores again!
Well, one team is very happy here.
He had, up until the Nice game, scored 2 and 2 games, and now he has 3 and 4.
Well, they've knocked the ball about well, Martin, and...
Still 75% in goals-to-game ratio. Win the league for Marcus Lopez. He's still the top goal scorer.
Sidibe.
Oh, great pass from Lopez to Burvo. Well, then skits there and makes sure or this doesn't go to 3-0 before half time. They seem to be taking their goal kicks short but out to the wide areas.
Gian Moutinho.
Next goal kick, I'm gonna put the player I'm controlling over by the wide defender. To see if that will make him air play to my play out forward or if they
trying to switch on the
they go long. They're okay. And again, they could just play out to the other wide defender. I have no idea. I have no guarantee of which defender they might go for. I guess it might depend on which side the goal kick is from.
And he shoots from the free kick, and he can't get it.
Kurtz, have another go! The Preville! Ah, oh, it's gonna come to Lopez.
The cross coming in.
Whips it in. The Preville! 3-0 just before half. On to Bruno. Deprivo. Oh, what makes it 3-0?
It's a wonderful ability to have, isn't it? Oh. It's all about timing that volley.
And things are not looking good for Monaco.
It's
his first goal since the first game of the season. So, a bit of a weight off his shoulder, as it were.
You don't often get a first half as one-sided as this one. They've been very good, the team that are leading, of course. Sidibe.
Won't come under pressure.
Strong challenge. On the attack here.
Lopez.
Stopped emphatically and just.
Oh, Fabinho gets that.
Very encouraging. Trip.
Come on, you can get there. Or just let him run away from you. Good challenge.
Discussion now about how to make the most.
Or not, according to the referee, because it's a free kick.
That ball belongs to the
goalkeeper. Easy take for Timo Horn. Oh, what a throw! Ah, oh, he's quick though. His first touch.
Well, he doesn't come
up and down.
He's the kind of player that can make a difference.
This time is much better. He's getting away from Prim. He's quite dark. Oh, it's come to Lopez! Shouldn't have hit that first time. Brilliant. I knew as soon as he passed it.
Gets his foot in there. Decision.
As soon as I passed the ball, I pressed circle so he would hit it first time, and then I was like, oh shit, I shouldn't have done that.
Now they've got a chance in this
Lopez. It's quite dull! Ooh!
Well, it's one of the best opportunities of the match, that, and he should. He knows he should have done better.
Hit the support thing for the net. And the back post thing.
Got the tackle in. Well, he's got away from him.
Too bad.
Made that look like a poor pass, but a very good interception.
I wonder, is it pronounced Tufan or Tufan?
Lille, they'll be facing Southampton away from that. Yeah, really looking.
I wonder. That's a free kick.
And they've got a chance to really make the most.
Torre, that's the guy who's failed an attempt at block earlier. For the first goal. He was the player who was on the line.
Here's the shot from the free kick.
Krucha! We'll win the corner. The free kick was too close to the keeper. Herbert. That may end up being a good thing. No, if they counter me, it won't be. Oh.
That's not a good cross at all.
Yup. Yeah.
Just over a quarter of an hour left on my watch.
The Curvo.
Looking for
Lopez.
There goes the cross.
Loses his man. And doesn't care. Or gets the better Torre again. And it's 4-0. Oh.
Almost, they saw
maybe taking a slight deflection off of him. I don't know why it'll show you a slow replay of what happened. Whatever the case, it's 4-0. Well, and it is not a good deck. Need that Torre.
Carl. Great piece of play. Honest challenges from both of them.
He's been booked. He's been played by a central midfielder. If he's not careful, he'll get himself sent off.
At the corner. Supporting player alongside. And here's the shot.
Oh, Sancair going for the hat trick. Less likely people scored hat tricks in this game.
Just as well. The approach play looked very encouraging. Four more minutes. Now it goes into the
square draw.
Where they've got a winger waiting.
Whips it, and looking for the Preville! I'll take this chance to bring on Benenzia. Purely so he doesn't complain that he didn't get a chance to play.
Lille ready to make a change now. And the time to be added on here is a minimum of 3 minutes. Luciano Narsi.
Square draw. Okay, I'm an open opportunity here. Benzia might get a shot. He'll get a goal. Oh, much better. Are you even kidding me? This is his first freaking involvement in the whole match. He just came on. And he scores the fifth goal.
I'm afraid the winners deserve this margin.
Well, he's completely unmarked. I'm pretty sure that's his first touch of the ball. Right there. First touch of the ball. Bang. Oh, you can't even write this stuff. That's his first goal of the season. Oh, unfreaking believable.
That's the end of the match. And the final score is 5-0. Well, it turned out.
And as if to say, hey, yeah, that's enough, the referee immediately blows the full-time whistle well after the restart. Pure and utter domination, look at that. 20 shots, 11 on target. It's 5-0. Pure, utter domination.
Liga 1. Angers 0, Dijon 2, Wiengong 1.
Hey, my ring went up again. Why did it go up again? Who knows?
5, Monaco 0, Nice 0, Olympic Marseille 1, Bastia 2.
Am I complaining? Hell no.
Let's see what that means for the league tables. At the top of the table, we have new leaders in Lille with 12 points.
Two of the youth players I signed up at the end of the last episode have gone off. Good. Certainly grew up, which we're in. Okay, Ray. I'm the sooner. Or I will give them their time to shine in the first team.
Bottom of the table, Nancy with 1 point. And then reading up the table, second bottom, Metz with 1 point. Third bottom, Montpellier with 3 points. Fourth bottom, Nice with 3 points.
Could be okay. Terrible. Oh, trash. Just, why are you a footballer, man? Why? You'd see the second team is going to pour a different formation to the main squad. Oh no, not again. At least I'm away for this match. And Southampton, it looks like their away jersey is not the same, pretty much the same color as their home jersey, because that would be fucking mentally retarded. It's Monaco. Where I'm gonna be wearing this twice. It's the third jersey. Well, wonders never cease. I don't know if I mentioned this in the previous career mode. I think I did. I either did mention it or I meant to mention it. Well, anyway, I will mention it here. I will only be going into the Europa League once. So after I complete this with Leo, and I win the Europa League, I won't be going into it again. I don't care if the team he happened to go to is in the Europa League or not. I couldn't give a flying piss. If it's not the Champions League, I really don't care. I'm okay with winning the Europa League once. So this will be the only time you see the Europa League. If I'm not in the Champions League from in future for secondary career modes during this FIFA, then you won't see any European football, whether the team is in European football or not. Well, obviously if they're not, but if they are and they're not in the Champions League, obviously then they're in the Europa League. Makes sense? Good? Yes? Good? Very well. And this will be the case for all future FIFAs as that I am recording gameplay for.
Now Van Dijk.
I'll do one career mode with Europa League football if the team is in Europa League football. Or the game puts the team in Europa League football. Well, why did the game put Leo in Europa League football? I don't even know if they are in it. But the game randomly put me in. I didn't tell it to put me in. I didn't put myself in. And when I get random selection for the second time, it put me in Europa League. I didn't even know it put me in Europa League until all the till the owners said they wanted me to reach the semi-final. What was it, the final? Either way, they said they wanted a good run in the Europa League. I was like, I'm not even in the Europa League. And then I looked, and sure enough, oh, I am in Europa League. So yeah.
He's taken on his man and beaten.
Not for any you younger FIFA player users out there. If you set the game up to include European football on the first go-around, make sure you check whether your team is in the Europa League or not. Because the Champions League is the one that pops up at first. And if you don't switch it to see who's in the Europa League, then you might get a surprise that you may or may not want. In this case, I didn't know we were in the Europa League, but if anything, it's a blessing in disguise. Because it means I'm getting this one Europa League run out of the way straight away. Well, second career mode, but still pretty early.
His size and agility to make that wonderful save.
Not really anything special about that save. Now that save is a pretty special one. That could have been a goal. If Frogster didn't save it. Bit of an obvious statement, but true.
Oh, he had a real go.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
He was in the right place at the right time. Just couldn't provide the finishing touch.
Could be dangerous. They're cut out by the defender. Bertrand. Oriol Romeu. Ryan Bertrand, Shane Lock, he has such an appetite for the game because he'll chase down anything, anywhere.
He pops up in the most unusual position.
Bissouma.
Here comes a challenge.
Oh, that's a foul from Cedric. No, it isn't.
On the attack here. Excellent play to lose his marker.
I don't understand this game sometimes. Salty. Come on. Bissouma. The armory. Off him out. Oh. Oh, come on, Emil Fatano. We know you can do it. We remember your time in the Premier League.
Trying to switch on the
A freaking Van Dijk almost put it in his own net. Also, how does that not count as a back pass? Seriously, are something gonna break all the rules of the game? Any man get away with it in this competition?
So we've had the first 45 minutes of this match day one group stage game in the Euro League. I wonder what the second half will bring. We're about to find out, and here we go.
I think there's potential for it to get better because there seems to be a bit of tension in the air.
Benzia. This is the ball straight away to Davis. Oh.
Cedric. Here's Cedric Suarez. And he's got the ball away from him with the tackle. He's given possession away here. And here comes the counter attack.
Emil Furtado! Benzi has gonna score for 2 goals in 2 games. For the young, well, Algerian now.
On the spot, the scorer.
Well, let's take another look at the goal.
That's right. He's no longer French, is Benzia. I guess maybe he got tired of people comparing him to Benzema. Let's be honest. We all did. We were all like, he's like Benzema's younger brother. He's young, French, and he has some of the same letters.
Oriol Romeo. Spotted that
well. Here is Benzia. Huh? Oh, avoids the challenge like a boss. On the return ball. Was blasted over the bar.
Just took his eye off the ball.
Probably should have gone sweaty there.
He's on a high after scoring already, but let himself down there.
Ryan Mendes. Well, we're two.
Mendes.
Half an hour to go. Marvellous tackle.
Oh, get up, dude. Get up.
And he's threaded the path through neatly.
Oh, look at that. You heard me. Benzia! Of course not.
Well, we have heard from our sources inside Liverpool Football Club that the deal is done. I think it's out on the official media platforms now. They have made their signing.
Well, there were a few in for this boy, and this team, in paying around £55 million, made sure they got their man.
Cedric, looking for an opening with some good control builder.
Come on, get the ball. You know, I just realized I didn't check what the scoreline in the other match was. Should be paying attention. We can check it after the match.
That's gone out for a throwing.
Emil Furtado. Whoops in. Good ball! Bad header.
He really does connect well with those neck muscles.
Salty. He couldn't put it in the back of the net. I just noticed Southampton Brom, who fouled the excellent player.
Here's Cedric Suarez. Lille have possession here.
Oh, yes. As a, I mean, who's come up from defence for some reason? Emil Furtado, 2-0. Oh, that's why he came up, to get himself an assist.
It's reflected now on the scoreline. So a real captain's contribution here
with a fine goal.
Was a good goal, and it came at a...
He nodded in, and that should wrap up the 3 points in the first Europa League game for Leo. Get the fuck in.
Just widen the margin here to 2.
So, not quite the happy return he would have wanted, is it, for Buffel?
Onto the attack now. And that's broken up by the defender.
Can't keep it in, so Sam, they're going to have a attacking for really close to the goal. That's clear, no issues. And yeah, so El Patano. Yeah, this crisp passing. Amado! Off the post now again! Oh, for God's sake.
Added time will amount to 3 minutes at least.
3 minutes.
Nice save to play it back to the goalkeeper. He's good with his feet.
Last up on the pitch. There's the full-time whistle. 2-0 win. I don't know if that's going to be enough to put me top of it.
When they had the ball, which was
the first set of games, but it's you never know. We'll see. Show me the other results. I'm looking for... Who am I looking for? Krasnodar and... Aberdeen. I couldn't... they were probably right there, but I didn't see them.
1. Southampton 0. Lille 2. Spartak Moscow 1, West Ham United.
No, of course not. That would never work.
That's a
why would it work?
Rapid Vienna.
Office, no inbox. I'm looking for calendar. I'm going to go into view fixture. Oh, they drew 1-1, so I am top of the group. Way! Champion. Fantastic. In the next episode, I have games against Lorient and Toulouse. Sorry, move bias, forgot. And yeah. Until then, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Smash the like button if you did, subscribe if you're new. Until next time, I'll see you all. Have a very nice day. Peace.